Welcome to the Getting Started with GeoStudio video series. This tutorial introduces how to import and export DXF files in GeoStudio products. This video will also briefly explain how to import DXF files as pictures in GeoStudio products. We will start in AutoCAD, where we will add 5 layers representing different soil regions of a 2-dimensional slope. Here, 4 layers have already been drawn, and the final sand embankment will now be added as the final layer with the sloping surface. Note, it is important to create closed polylines for importing regions into GeoStudio products. It is also recommended to keep the polygons as simple as possible and to ensure that adjoining polylines share the same points along the adjoining edges to avoid collision errors. Once the DXF file has been created and saved, we can open a new project in GeoStudio. Here we are using a slope W limit equilibrium analysis to import the 5 soil layers as separate regions. We will go to File, Import Regions, and choose our DXF file that we just finished creating. The Import Regions from DXF window will open, and all 5 layers that were defined in AutoCAD are automatically selected. Here you can change which layers you want to import and suggest a scale and origin point. The origin point is based on the minimal extents of the polylines in the DXF using the coordinate system defined in AutoCAD, while the scale is determined by the polyline extents found in the DXF and the current GeoStudio page size. Note, the DXF files are unitless, so the GeoStudio engineering units will be used to interpret the DXF data. The Apply button can be used to visualize the regions created by the DXF file on the GeoStudio page, so that changes to the origin and scale minimal extents can be modified and visualized prior to leaving this screen. Now we can see the 5 soil regions have been defined as individual regions in GeoStudio. We will go to Key In, Regions, to review the regions we have just imported. Now the domain is ready to add materials and boundary conditions. Next, we can go to File, Export, to create a DXF file based on the regions we have imported into GeoStudio products. This option simply saves a drawing or picture of your GeoStudio problem. The definitions of the problem, such as the material properties or boundary conditions, are not stored in the exported DXF file. For DXF exports, you can check Export All Layers to export all objects, which includes all objects whether they are visible or not. If this checkbox is not chosen, only objects that are visible on the GeoStudio page using View Preferences will be exported in the DXF file. The objects saved in the DXF file are saved on named layers to match their view preference in GeoStudio. For example, geometry regions will be saved as a region layer, while the mesh is saved as a mesh layer. If you simply want to import a picture of your DXF file onto the GeoStudio Start page, you can simply go to Sketch, Pictures. Here you can add the DXF as a picture in the background of your domain. Note, the picture is not a part of the modeling domain and is simply a visualization tool. Note, if you want to view the GeoStudio file in a previous version of GeoStudio, you must use the Export Previous Version command and not the Export command. This will allow the file to be saved in a format that is readable by previous GeoStudio versions based on the chosen option from the drop-down menu. We have now reached the end of this introductory tutorial. Note that not all of the powerful features of GeoStudio 2012 have been used or discussed here. Further information on each command can be found in the online help, supporting documentation, as well as other tutorial videos of the Getting Started with GeoStudio video series. Thank you for watching.